Hi guys, my name is Sean. I am a houseplant enthusiast from Indonesia. In this channel, I discuss plant care and propagations. I really like to nerd out on the science behind what keeps our houseplants happy and how to multiply them in our homes. So if you're into that kind of content, do subscribe to my channel and send me likes. Today we will cover the Peperomia argyrea, or also known as the watermelon peperomia. Look how gorgeous the leaves are. A lot of you have asked me how I care for this, so today's video will cover that. I do have a few specimens in my care, some of them are a bit younger, so we will go through each one of them and see how they're doing. This guy in my hand, he is actually a plant rescue. I got him online and he died back completely, so I had to cut it down to the soil level. I was really surprised to see it sprout and grow into this. I had it indoors at first in my bedroom where it's got, you know, a little bit of air conditioning at night. And then I moved it outside because I had so many plants I couldn't take care of each one and water each one. So I let the rainwater take care of this plant. I occasionally water it when there's like a drought period. And it seemed to like it out there. It's grown huge, huge leaves. And I have actually taken a few of the naughty leaves, like this one here, where it's, and just plucked it off and propagated right back into soil and made a few more plants. I'll show you those later. So this is cuttings taken from that previous plant. As you can see, I took off some of the unhealthy leaves and they rooted anyways. Peperomias are very strong and resilient plants. And in my experience, I know that they will produce baby growths from under the soil anytime now. So this was rooted in water for about 4 weeks and then it's been in soil for about 2 weeks. Here's a cutting of a leaf that was deformed. I didn't want to leave this on the plant, and in about 2 weeks time it's given me roots. So I'm gonna put it back for another 2 weeks. As you can see, peperomia roots are super like hair-like and fine, so you want to be very careful when you handle these cuttings. So 2 more weeks and it's going into soil. So this guy, he didn't do so well. After my first peperomia argyrea died, I didn't know it was going to grow back, so I figured I'll buy another one from online. So I got this plant. I swear it was bigger than this when I got it. I may have a picture of it, but I'm not sure. And I've taken cuttings from him before, and the cutting has done better than this plant. I'll show you later. And I think one of the contributing factors to this plant not doing so well is the pot size. I mean, it's been kept in all the same conditions as the other plants, so there's no excuse. I think the pot size is too big. If you look at peperomias, they have very shallow, very tiny hair-like roots. I don't think it appreciates being in a pot this big. So I'm going to unpot this later for you guys, and we will study and see what's going on down there, and we will do an update later to see if changing the pot did fix this problem. Last but not least, we have this plant, which is actually 3 cuttings taken from the previous plant that didn't do so well. As you can see, it's grown pretty fast and the leaves are bigger and healthier. This is again 3 cuttings living in a tiny pot. So that's my theory about peperomias liking to be in tighter pots since their roots are so small. All right, let's talk about basic plant care. These guys are quite forgiving in my experience. They like medium to bright indirect light. Do not give them direct sunlight as they will burn. Although mine does get dappled light, dappled direct light sometimes. Do not keep them in the dark as they will lose the variegations. I'm not sure if this is even a variegation, it's the light colors on the leaves. And in terms of watering, I used to put my moisture meter in the soil every time I water, but I stopped doing that when I have over 500 plants. And what I do now is just squeeze the leaves gently, and if they give, such as this one, it's time to water. But if they're full, they will be firm and it will fight. It will not let you fold it. So I let them get rained on for the most part, and if I have a drought period, I do water them manually. Do not overwater them, they don't appreciate it. Again, if their leaves are firm, back off, do not water. And I don't have any pest pressures on these, thankfully. If you guys have, please comment below. And again, having them in very tight pots and a well-draining soil, I believe is the key to having them grow fast and strong. And fertilizing. I don't really fertilize these heavily. They're not heavy feeders, so go easy on them. They do grow towards the sun, so if you want a more even look, give them a rotate once in a while. I did not rotate these, so they're turning towards the sun. But I kind of like it that they're facing one way. In terms of soil medium, I don't think they mind any kind of soil that you give them. This one is in a particularly airy mix that probably resembles a jungle floor. I've also had this in cocoa peat, perlite, burnt rice hulls, and worm casting. So I find that they like it better in terracotta pots because terracotta obviously dries up 2 to 3 times faster than plastic pots. To propagate, simply pluck off one of the petioles from the stem and root it in water. It should take about 4 to 5 weeks. Again, we want to be careful with the root structure as it is very hairy and fine. Do not plant it in too deep. I had an experience where I planted one of the cuttings too deep and it did not do much and for a few months. I finally dug it up and I noticed that it was trying to grow babies, but they were buried deep in the soil. So that cutting actually survived. I repotted that, planted it in a more shallow depth. And let me show you right here. And this is one of these cuttings. It sprouted leaves after that. So one thing to add to peperomias is that they actually root from the edge of the petiole over here, where my pinky is. And the longer the petiole is, the slower the rooting process is. I've noticed that with a couple of propagates before. So you might want to cut it up to like here, like the halfway point, which is what I'm going to do next. Alright, so I made the cut and it's going into my water propagation. It's next to my hoyas. And a little bit of bonus, one of the petioles actually fell off when I was filming, and I don't know, it doesn't look like a healthy leaf, but I've got nothing to lose, so I'm gonna just poke a hole and stick it in, and let's see what happens to this guy if he wants to live. There you go. When you propagate your plant, you need to put it in a bright location. Not direct sun, but bright, because the leaves actually need the sunlight to produce energy for the roots. So do not stick them in a dark spot. All right, so I unpotted him and look at how small the roots are. It doesn't have a lot of roots. I'm not sure if this is because the plant is not healthy or it's just normal for them to have such shallow roots. It did not need to be in a pot this size. This pot is too big for it. The root ball is probably only 5% of the total volume of the soil. I'm going to move him into a smaller pot over here. All right, so finally I have this guy potted up and it looks happy here, presumably. And its root ball is probably about 20% of the size of the pot. And that's probably a good ratio for any plants, especially peperomias. So thanks for watching my video, guys. Don't forget to like and subscribe my channel. And I will see you in the next video.